Today we're getting into the Halloween spirit by showing you how to become a ghost. This tutorial was requested by you guys, so if there is something that you want to see, let us know in the comment section down below. And like this video while you're at it, it really helps out the channel. This tutorial can be completely followed in HitFilm Express, but there is an optional detail of using the atomic particle,
which is included in the motion audio visual pack. But for demo purposes, you can still use it in this tutorial.
Ready. We're of course filming this all on a green screen so we can eliminate the background, make our ghost transparent, and slot them into our clean plate.
We shot our actress Sarah on a green screen and then had her act out the motion of floating by transferring her weight from one leg to the other. This was because we had limited space on our green screen but wanted to show some form of movement. Simple, but effective. The costume is very important. As well as setting the ghost in a particular era, we needed to keep the texture and highlights to maintain some form of the figure once we applied our effects.
You may also notice that we're going with an underlighting. This also gives us a unworldly, evil, demonic vibe that is so traditional in horror.
The only additional thing you'll need is a clean plate of your scene. For an additional touch, throw in a light of the same color as your ghost into the area they'll be standing in. This'll act as a reference and aid your composite. Once you've got your footage, over in HitFilm, start off with your footage in a composite shot and begin by keying the green or blue using either the chroma key or color difference key, masking out only the area you want to keep by using the masking tools. We're going to start off by adding some detail by applying a brightness and contrast to make a strong divide between a highlight and shadows. To create an undead vibe for your actor, apply a color temperature or hue, saturation, and lightness to produce a colder image. With our actor looking a little dead now, let's work on getting them ghostly. From the matte enhancement folder of the keying tools, find and apply matte cleaner, with an increase in the smooth and feather sliders, softening any strong harsh edges. If like us you're a big fan of Ghostbusters, apply a tint to your ghost. Going with a green or blue tone really works well, but be sure to work with the light reference you decided to go for on set. Enhance the details of your ghost by bringing in an unsharpen effect from the sharpen dropdown. Going with either a portrait or boost contrast preset depending on the size of your shot angle. With our subject set, let's start turning them ghostly with a glow. This is going to vary depending on what you've captured, so fiddle with the settings till you get something appropriate. You can even double them up.
All right.
In preparation for the other layers, we're going to bring the opacity down to 33%. To bring up the details of our ghost, we're going to apply an edge glow. Duplicate your footage layer, this time renaming it edge glow. If you go into the stylized effects, apply Find Edges to this layer under the key effect. You may need to alter the glow settings once again to get something a bit more suitable, but once happy, apply a diffuse or blur to this layer to extend the glow's radius, finishing it off by setting the blend mode to add. For those ghostly wisps and overlaid textures, we're going to generate a new plane layer and apply fractal noise. Activate the pen tool and mask around your actor, and be sure to alter the feather to a high value. I'll keep the fractal noise in its default, but for more detail, I'm going to go into the transform settings and decrease the scale. Now to simulate motion, we'll enter the position settings, set a keyframe at the beginning of our sequence, head on over to the end, and raise the value on only the y-axis. This will give the impression that the smoke is rising. It wouldn't be heat without some distortion, so apply heat distortion underneath the fractal and dial up the scale to the maximum value. And the distortion to negative 50. If you find this is looking a little too fast in your render, head on down to the animation settings and lower the wind and noise values. Now, much like our other layers, apply a tint to match our ghost's color, along with a glow effect. Then, over in the blend mode, set this to screen. For even more texture, you can duplicate this layer and alter the settings for different noise and animations. For example, with our ghost, I altered the second fractal to a wisp type and added a diffuse to soften it over our subject. This ghost was influenced by the one scene in Ghostbusters and a little of the spirit effect from the Netflix show Locke Key. These little edge particles were a nice detail and something that we could do with the atomic particle. Start off by duplicating your footage layer and removing all effects but the key. We're going to need its luma mode. If you're using color difference key, you'll need to select view matte, or if you're in chroma key, you'll need to switch the view mode to matte. Make this layer its own composite shot and jump in. As we're wanting the particles to feature around the edges, we're going to do something a little different and duplicate this clip once more. And on the top layer, switch off the matte view to reveal our key. Once again, find a matte cleaner and increase the choke and feather to really soften the edges. Now from the gradient and fill effects, apply a fill and change the color to black. Now we can jump back into our main composite shot. And to remove everything but the edges we want, apply Demul. You should now have everything but the white areas. We can now apply our atomic particles from the particles and simulation effects. If you've never used the atomic particle effect before, I highly recommend you checking out one of our other tutorials. As for now, I'll just be going over the settings we'll be needing. First up, I'll open the particle placement and alter the number of particles. You can add as many as you need, but as I'd like this to be quite subtle, I'm going for around 200 on the X and Y. In the particle appearance settings, I'll resize to something that works, with a size randomness to 1, along with an increase in the disperse amount to make this feel less uniform. Then altering the fractal settings to add a soft drifting animation. I found that lowering the wavelength especially helped this. Much like the other layers, we'll then apply a glow and either a diffuse or blur to soften the edges, and set the blend mode to add. Last little thing is to create more contrast by generating a grade layer, applying curves, and just crushing the shadows and bringing up the highlights. Now all we need to do is bring our ghost into a clean plate, create a new composite shot with our clean plate image or footage, and also drag in your ghost composite shot. Now this is the easy part. Lower the opacity to around 50, duplicate it, and set the blend mode to add or screen to bring out the highlights. If you want to add more unnatural effects to your ghost, play around with the speed effect to really make the motion feel like it's drifting through the air. Thank you for watching this tutorial. We really do hope that you've enjoyed it. Don't forget to like and subscribe because we have a bunch of fun effects coming very, very soon. You're not going to want to miss them. I'll see you next time!